Today, I'm going to discuss yet another in the seemingly endless paradigm-shattering discoveries that have dismantled, uprooted, or outright falsified the standard Big Bang Lambda Cold Dark Matter model of the universe. I'll briefly note that moments before I began this recording, I read a New Science headline stating that the so-called cosmic microwave background, or the radiation source that cosmologists have long described as the quote afterglow of the Big Bang, may not actually exist at all. As a physicist from the University of Bonn states, our results are a problem for the standard model of cosmology. It might be necessary to rewrite the history of the universe, at least in part. Longtime viewers will remember Dr. Pierre-Marie Robitaille's presentation at Thunderbolts EU 2014, entitled The Cosmic Microwave Background, which can be viewed on the Thunderbolts YouTube channel. Now, before I begin, I'd like to share an especially salient quote from Thomas Kuhn's seminal book, The Structure of Scientific Revolutions. Kuhn wrote, "The decision to reject one paradigm is always simultaneously the decision to accept another, and the judgment leading to that decision involves the comparison of both paradigms with nature and with each other." This statement encapsulates the formula, if you will, that I always try to bring to the video presentations on this channel. The stunning revelation I've discovered is that when the paradigm of standard cosmology is compared to the paradigms of the electric universe and plasma cosmology, it is the latter whose ability to predict and explain reality reigns superior, and this disparity grows with constantly improving technological data. Nowhere is this more self-evident than in scientists' observations of objects in the so-called early universe. As we've discussed ad nauseum here, the James Webb Space Telescope has revealed object after object whose apparent size, maturity, and chemical compositions are totally discordant with the standard theory of the universe's supposed 13.8 billion-year history. This includes grand design spiral galaxies that appear to have emerged exponentially earlier than even thought possible in any Big Bang model. And yet, even long before JWST was launched, cosmologists were troubled by observations of impossibly huge objects whose apparent size is so great they could not have formed in the conjectured time and conditions of the Big Bang universe. This has only led to further epicycles added to the Big Bang story, including more recent efforts to double the age of the universe to 26 billion years. Unsurprisingly, the hits just keep coming for plasma cosmology and the electric universe, as nature simply refuses to bend to mainstream cosmologists' expectations. Last year, a team of scientists led by astronomer Alexia Lopez discovered a structure so apparently huge, it shouldn't exist. The structure that astronomers call the, quote, Big Ring appears to be 1.3 billion light years in diameter, and as noted in a recent Science Alert report, it, quote, doesn't match any known structure or formation mechanism. The report describes just how problematic the finding is for proponents of Big Bang cosmology. A colossal structure in the distant universe is defying our understanding of how the universe evolved, and light that has traveled for 6.8 billion years to reach us. Astronomers have found a giant, almost perfect ring of galaxies, some 1.3 billion light years in diameter. It doesn't match any known structure or formation mechanism. The Big Ring, as the structure has been named, could mean that we need to amend the standard model of cosmology. The article notes that the scientists who made the discovery also found a similar structure in 2021 in the same distant region of space. Alexia Lopez states, "Neither of these two ultra-large structures is easy to explain in our current understanding of the universe, and their ultra-large sizes, distinctive shapes, and cosmological proximity must surely be telling us something important. But what exactly?" The scientists note that they have ruled out the possibility that these apparently giant, baffling structures are so-called baryon acoustic oscillations, or, quote, fossilized acoustic waves, which astrophysicists conjecture froze in space after propagating in the wake of the Big Bang. For one thing, the absolute size limit of those hypothetical objects is 1 billion light years. For another, and this fact is important, the shape of the so-called Big Ring is not actually that of a ring, but a corkscrew, which only appears as a ring due to its alignment relative to the observer's perspective on Earth. Now, as we already noted, for decades, seemingly impossibly huge objects, and objects that appear far too mature for their apparent age, have been a thorn in the sides of cosmologists for decades. However, another lingering unexplained problem for cosmologists is observations such as these that undermine the cosmological principle, the notion that space should be consistent in appearance in all directions in the cosmos. Alexia Lopez states, "We expect matter to be evenly distributed everywhere in space when we view the universe on a large scale, so there should be no noticeable irregularities above a certain size." Cosmologists calculate the current theoretical size limit of structures to be 1.2 billion light years, yet both of these structures are much larger. The giant arc is almost three times bigger, and the big ring circumference is comparable to the giant arc's length. Now, 2 weeks ago, the Thunderbolts Project published Matt Finn's presentation, which offered a comprehensive review of Halton Arp's revolutionary thesis, particularly in light of the devastating impact of JWST and other evidential data on the now shattered Big Bang paradigm. As viewers of this channel have known for a long time, Arp and his contemporaries, such as Jeffrey and Margaret Burbidge and others, discovered evidence of close interactions between quasars and other objects with widely disparate redshifts. As Wall Thornhill explained in his final presentation for the Thunderbolts Project, JWST has provided incredible affirmation of Arp. Wall highlights the photographs you see on your screen of Stefan's quintet, which show a highly redshifted quasar in front of the galaxy NGC 7319. Said galaxy is only a few hundred million light years away, and yet in conventional reasoning, the redshift of the quasar that is clearly in front of it places it at roughly 10 billion light years away. In other words, it is no longer evidentially warranted for astrophysicists to conclude that cosmological redshift is a reliable indicator of an object's distance from the observer on Earth. In the cosmos, as Arp proposed, and which the electric universe agrees with, highly redshifted objects indicate their youthfulness. Again, a number of plasma scientists, beginning with Winston H. Bostick of MIT Laboratories and Anthony Peratt of Los Alamos, have been able to reproduce the structure and movements of galaxies in experiments with electric currents. Filamentary networks connect objects at all scales across the cosmos, a fact that mainstream astrophysics does actually acknowledge in its discussions of the so-called cosmic web. In reality, these plasma networks are the, quote, highways along which electric currents travel and are the organizing force by which objects form, including the largest cosmological structures. When it comes to a giant structure that is apparently in the form of a corkscrew, I'll note that in 2008, Wall Thornhill wrote in an article on his website, holoscience.com, "Cosmic discharges take the form of rotating pairs of Birkeland filaments, which drill into a surface to form rotary and corkscrew patterns. Corkscrew-walled craters are found on the moon. Changing discharge current may generate corkscrew patterns, and pulsations in the current, or cylindrical particle beams, create concentric configurations." And here, we have to keep in mind the fundamental fact that the electromagnetic force is 10 to the 39th power more powerful than gravity. Every assumption that astrophysicists have about the timescales of the formative processes of celestial objects is thus in need of the most radical reassessment. No position of the electric universe has been more emphatically confirmed than the statement that, quote, "there are no islands in the universe." Returning now to the statement of Thomas Kuhn that began this video, when it comes to the question of the universe's origins, I always defer to the position of the late Wall Thornhill, that the electric universe and plasma cosmology have no need to compete with the creation myths of standard cosmology. The humbling reality is that humankind does not yet have sufficient information or understanding to compose a reliable picture of the universe's origins and extent. If institutionalized science is able to recognize the validity of this position, it will represent an enormous gain in the integrity of all scientific investigations into the nature of the physical universe and our place in it.